As of September 17, 2023, there are currently 46 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet. One of these erupting volcanoes is located in a remote Russian island chain which stretches between the peninsula of Kamchatka and the Japanese island of Hokkaido. There, on one of the Kuril Islands, is the Ebeko volcano, which has been continuously erupting since June of 2021. This eruptive period has consisted of intermittent volcanic explosions which have regularly ejected plumes of ash to a height of 10,000 to 12,000 feet. With this being said, here are this week's major volcano-related news stories. In Hawaii, the Kilauea volcano erupted anew, beginning its first summit eruption in 83 days. Meanwhile, in the Philippines, the Taal volcano produced an increased amount of volcanic fog known as Vog. And, in what is this week's top story, Alaska's Shishaldin volcano produced a very powerful eruption, sending a sustained plume of ash to a height of 12.8 kilometers or 42,000 feet. There were warning signs that some form of a major eruption was going to occur for much of the prior 18 hours, as the RSAM values, which indicate the amount of average ground shaking at the volcano, had been continuously increasing, going from a value of 20 at 3 a.m. to a value of 2040 at 6 p.m. on September 15th. This signaled that magma was advancing upwards towards Shishaldin's summit through its magma conduit, moving alongside highly pressurized gases. These would encounter a plug of ash and lava, build further in pressure, before finally destroying the plug in a sub-plinian eruption. This sub-plinian eruption lasted for 100 minutes before waning in intensity, becoming intermittent, and then stopping altogether. During this eruption sequence, the National Weather Service issued a notice to the cities of King Cove, False Pass, and Cold Bay, which warned that a trace amount of ash could fall, perhaps totaling a little less than 0.3 inches or 0.762 millimeters. What had just occurred was Shishaldin's second largest historical eruption ever recorded, only creating a slightly shorter eruption column than the April 19, 1996 eruption, which reached approximately 10,000 feet higher. While no significant damage was generated by this eruption due to the sparse regional population, it is likely to generate significant lahars on Shishaldin slopes over the next several days, which will not reach any settlements. In Hawaii, on September 10th at 3:13 p.m. local time, a body of lava burst through the caldera floor of the Kilauea volcano, starting a new eruption. This eruption followed a signal of magma rising to the surface, which was observed only 41 minutes earlier. The first vent to erupt initially created a lava fountain which was 46 meters or 151 feet in height. By 15 minutes later, 9 vents were erupting along a 4,100-foot-long fissure. Some of these vents interestingly erupted outside of the inner down-dropped block created by Kilauea's 2018 caldera collapse, the first time this had occurred since the 2018 collapse. Whereas the entire length of the fissure was emitting lava on September 10th, by 4 days later, only the middle 20% was erupting molten rock. Like witnessed at most recent Kilauea summit eruptions, the amount of lava being erupted is notably decreasing, and this decrease will likely continue until the undetermined time when the eruption ends. In the Philippines, a special notice was published regarding the Taal volcano on September 15th. As the amount of sulfur dioxide, its main crater lake on Taal's central island and its related vents has increased from 1,141 tons a day on August 24th to 3,264 tons a day on September 15th. Due in part to fairly weak winds over the last 72 hours, this plume rose to a height of 3,000 meters, which is a little more than triple what is normal for this volcano. As a result, volcanic smog covered a much wider landmass than is typical, which people should limit their exposure to and largely stay indoors when it is thick. While the northern section of Taal's central island has been experiencing inflation for the past several weeks, this does not necessarily point towards an imminent eruption. As, generally speaking, since February of 2020, Taal's eruptions occur after days where more than 8,000 to 10,000 tons of sulfur dioxide were observed. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on September 16th of 2023. Thanks for watching. I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.